Welcome to Set to Carry Online Nursing channel. This is your quiz time. Here we are going to discuss 29 questions. In this quiz, we are going to show the questions only. You are going to find the answers. At the end of the video, you can check your answers are right or not in the comment box. I am going to give all the 29 questions answers there. You can go and check it last. The main aim of this quiz competition or quiz contest is to check your current level of knowledge. Set to Carry Online Nursing channel is helping you in all the ways of preparing for your upcoming nursing officer exams. Before going to today's video, please subscribe to our channel if you have not yet subscribed. Let's go for the first question of the day. Zollinger-Ellison syndrome is characterized by option A, fulminating ulcer in stomach and duodenum. Option B, recurrent ulceration despite adequate therapy. Question number C, non-beta islet cell tumors of the pancreas. Option D, all of the above. Guess the right answer. Zollinger-Ellison syndrome is characterized by, the right answer is option D, all of the above. Now we move on to question number 2. Case fatality rate is used to know the option A, prevalence of the disease, B, incidence of the disease, C, severity of the disease, D, control of the disease. Case fatality rate is used to know the right answer. Choose the correct answer here. The right answer is severity of the disease, option C. Question number 3. The family where the parents have separated or divorced due to the disharmony is known as option A, problem family, B, broken family, C, nuclear family, D, joint family. Guess the right answer here. It's question from sociology. The broken family, option B, is the correct answer. Question number 34. The benefit of a health program or measured in a natural unit is option A, cost effectiveness analysis, B, cost benefit analysis, C, cost utility analysis, D, cost minimization analysis. The benefit of your health programs are measured in natural unit is known as option A, cost effectiveness analysis. Question number 35. The content of iodine in iodized salt at consumer level should be option A, 20 parts per million, B, 15 parts per million, C, 50 parts per million, D, 75 parts per million. What is the content of iodine in iodized salts? The consumer level is option B, 15 parts per million. Question number 36. One of the objectives in revised National Tuberculosis Control Program is option A, cure rate at least 85% among new sputum positive cases, B, cure rate of 100% among new sputum positive cases, C, cure rate of 50% among new sputum positive cases, option D, cure rate of 60% among new sputum positive cases. Guess the right answer. The right answer is option A, cure rate at least 85% among new sputum positive cases. 37. The reason for presence of glucose in oral rehydration solution in preventive social medicine is Option A to give energy, B to stop diarrhea, C to kill bacteria, D to promote the absorption of sodium and water from the intestine. Why glucose is present in oral rehydration solution? The right answer is option D, to promote the absorption of sodium and water from the intestine. Move on to question number 38. The period of validity of an international certificate of yellow fever vaccine is option A, 5 years, option B, 15 years, option C, 10 years, and D, 20 years. The right answer for this question, the validity period of yellow fever vaccine is 10 years. Option C is the correct one. Question number 39. The following is an important indicator to measure the incidence of malaria in community. Option A, annual falciparum incidence. Option B, slight positivity rate. C, infant parasite rate. D, annual parasite incidence. The right answer is option D, annual parasite incidence is an important indicator to measure the incidence of malaria in a community. Question number 40. Sensitivity means option A, true positive, B, false positive, C, true negative, and D is false negative. The right answer, sensitivity means option A, true positive, is the correct answer. Question number 41. The dengue fever is transmitted by the mosquito. Option A, Culex, B, Anopheles, C, Aedes aegypti, option D, Mannosonides. Which mosquito transmitting dengue fever? Right answer is Aedes aegypti. Option C is the correct answer. Question number 42. Human anatomical waste is disposed by one of the following color bags. Option A, red color bag. B, yellow color bag. C, black color bag. And D is white color bag. So in which color bag we dispose the human anatomical waste? Option B, yellow color bag, is the right answer. 43. Dribbling of saliva from the angle of mouth suggests option A, hanging. Option B, antemortem drowning. C, manual strangulation. Option D, antemortem burns. Dribbling of saliva from the angle of mouth suggests which method of dying? The right answer is option A, hanging. 44. Deposition of calcium in dying tissue is called option A, metastatic calcification, B, dystrophic calcification, C, heterotrophic calcification, D, normal calcification. Deposition of calcium in dying tissue is called option B, dystrophic calcification. 45. Pain in inflammation is mediated by option A, histamine and nitric oxide, B, prostaglandins and interleukins, C, interferons and free radicals, option D, prostaglandins and bradykinins. Pain in inflammation is mediated by option D, prostaglandins and bradykinin, is the exactly right answer for this question. 46. Question number 46. Causes of secondary brain injury is option A, pyrexia, B, hypotension. B, seizures and metabolic disturbance. C, low cerebral perfusion pressure. And D is all of the above. The secondary cause of brain injury. The right answer is option D, all of the above. Question number 47. Tetanus is caused by option A, Clostridium perfringens, B, Clostridium tetani, C, Bacillus coli, and D is Staphylococcus aureus. The organism which causes tetanus is option B, Clostridium tetani. 48. In intake of unpasteurized milk causes option A, yellow fever, B, brucellosis, C, pulmonary tuberculosis, D, enteric fever. Intake of unpasteurized milk cause option B, brucellosis is the right answer. 49. Animal reservoir of swine influenza viruses. Option A, field mice, B, urban rats, C, pigs, D, Calamus callosus. So, which is the animal reservoir for swine influenza virus? That is the C, pigs is the correct answer. Question number 50. The antidote of cyanide poisoning is option A, atropine, B, 2-pralidoxin, C, sodium nitrite and sodium thiosulfate, D, none of the above. The cyanide poisoning antidote is option C, sodium nitrite and sodium thiosulfate. Sodium nitrite with sodium thiosulfate. 51. Location and secretion of Leydig cells are option A, location liver and secreting cholesterol, B, ovary and it secretes estrogen. Option C, testis secretes testosterone. D, pancreas which produces glucogen. So the Leydig cell is present in option C, testis, and it produces testosterone. 52. What instruction is most appropriate in patient with trigeminal neuralgia to prevent triggering of the pain? Option A, drink cool fluids. B, avoid oral hygiene. C, apply warm compressions. Option D, chew on the affected side. So in patient with neurology or trigeminal neurology, to prevent the triggering of pain, the patient should chew on the unaffected side. Option D is the correct answer. 53. Which of the following hormone is responsible for fight or flight response? Option A, corticosterone, B, cortisol, C, adrenaline, D, estrogen. The right answer is adrenaline is the hormone which is responsible for fight or flight response. 54. The total volume of CSF secreted in a day. Option A, 100 ml, B, 1000 ml, C, 500 ml, and D is 150 to 200 ml. The 500 ml of CSF is secreted per day. Next question. Which of the following center is situated in medulla oblongata? A, cardiovascular center, B, respiratory center, C, reflex centers of vomiting, and D is all the above. The right answer is all the centers given here are present in medulla oblongata. Option D. Question number 56. After 1 hour after birth, the nurse can expect a neonate to be option A, hyper-responsive to the stimuli, B, relaxed and sleeping quietly, C, intensely alert with wide open, D is crying and cranky. The right answer is option B, relaxed and sleeping quietly after 1 hour of birth. Question number 57. Which is the most important test the nurse should check to determine whether a transplanted kidney is working or not? Option A, 24 hours urine output. B, renal ultrasound. C, WBC count. D, serum creatinine level. The right answer here is option D. The nurse should check the serum creatinine level 24 hours after kidney transplantation to ensure the kidney is functioning right or not. Question number 58. The nurse should explain to a client that breastfeeding is always contraindicated with option A, inverted nipples, B, hepatitis C, C, herpes genitalis, D, mastitis. So in which condition the breastfeeding is contraindicated? The right answer is option B, hepatitis. Let's go to the 59. Psychotherapy technique effective in obsessive rumination is option A, exposure prevention technique. Option B, thought stopping technique. C, sensitization. And D is flooding. The right answer, in case of obsessive rumination, thought stopping technique will be very effective. The right answer is option B. If you like this quiz competition, please like this video and write comment about the questions here. Also, you can see these two videos. If you like, you can watch it. Thanks for watching Satu Carry Online Nursing Channel. Tomorrow we will meet again with another good questions. Take care. Bye-bye.